Hi guys. This is a story that's 4 months in the making. On July 2nd, 2016, I lost my flying cinema x24 that I had just built. I lost it in the mountains. I lost it with a GoPro on it. Today, I recovered it. So let me tell you the story of how I recovered it and the effort that I put into actually getting it back. And we're talking a serious amount of effort. I went to the mountains at least 4 times looking for the quad. Well, I'll tell you about it. But first off, here is the last thing, the last I saw of the quad. So when the quad fell, we did a little bit of exploring, tried to cross the river, realized it was just too high, we couldn't cross. So waited a couple days and went up with a friend, Gonzalo, to try to rescue the quad again. This time taking a little bit of a hike. It's about a 5 kilometer hike. We had to go about 5 kilometers upstream, cross the nearest bridge, and then try to hike back down. Unfortunately, all did not go well. Here we are, just about to start out. Gonzalo and your faithful host, Matt, got my pack all loaded up. Gonzalo has his pack quite a bit less, so probably I'm going to be hurting at the end of this. And we've got a little bit of a walk to go. I don't know if you can see this, but way, way down there in the valley, we need to go all the way down there. So it's a good 5 kilometers hike, and hopefully we'll find the drone. We'll see. I'm a little bit worried that if we'll find the drone and the GoPro. If we don't find the GoPro, then I'm going to be very, very unhappy because that's got a lot of good footage on it. But I'm bringing my alien, so at least I'll get some more footage, hopefully.
Hay una buena posibilidad de pasar sin mojarse.
Veamos.
Ahí está más difícil.
Sí,
pero ahí lo veo más probable.
Okay. Subimos y ver. Entonces, primer desafío. First challenge. Cross this small little river. Let's see where we can cross. And here we go. Let's see how cold this is going to be. My bet is fucking cold. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh, it's nice and cold. And slippery. Oh. Ho, ho, ho. Oh, shit. Oh my God. And attempt number one failed. Came to some washouts along the trail that were just too steep and too risky. Basically dropped straight down into the river. We could have crossed them, but it was risky. So I made the call, turn back, and we'll try a different way. Possibly a boat. Possibly try to rescue it with another quad, but not walking. At least not that way. Not that trail. Just impossible. So we'll have to see what happens next. So some of you guys asked why I just didn't cross the river. It looks so small. Well, I think this will probably answer your questions on why I thought that might have been a bad idea. My quad is up there. This is what separates me from my quad. And as you can see, at no point does it look crossable. At no point. And let me tell you, that water is freaking cold. The next attempt we made was with Francisco. We were up in the mountains one day for work, and coming back down we saw the river was fairly low, so we tried to cross, and we did. We did a little bit of searching, probably searched for about 2 hours and just didn't find it. About 2 weeks later I went up with my flying Cinetank gimbal quad, tried to search for it that way, and I just couldn't find it. There's just not enough resolution on the GoPro. So that led to attempt number three, I believe, to search for it. This is just before flying to Hawaii. I was trying to recover the GoPro, so I had a GoPro for Hawaii, and unfortunately this didn't work either. You'll see that I say at one point that I think the quad is below where I am, and I was wrong. I spent all day searching, and it was just wrong. So here we are. I'm on the way to Paso Pelenche. This is not a flying mission. This is not a work mission. It's Monday. It's October 10th. This is a holiday here, so I've got the day off. And I'm heading up to the mountains to recover my quad. My main mission today is recover my flying Cinema X24 that is lost in the mountains. This will be the third or fourth attempt that I've made to recover the quad. The last couple of times I was able to, well, there was one period where I was able to get to the location where the quad went down, but I wasn't actually able to find the quad. Today the mission is to do a really good search of that area. I've got one or two more potential sites where it should be or could be. I've flown a couple missions with the big quad trying to find where it went down, look for any trace of it, but the thing is the GoPro doesn't have enough resolution to pick up just small quads like that. I had a couple potential spots and went in another mission, checked out those spots with more detail, you know, getting down real close to the ground, trying to figure out if that was it, and it turned out to be a little bush instead of a quad. So yeah, big failure there. So hopefully today I'm just going to go. I'm prepared. I don't have any quads. I don't have any other distractions. I've got my music and headphones and lots of supplies, water, food, etc., etc. The idea is to basically search until it gets dark, or a little bit before it gets dark, and hopefully come back with the quad. Really, I'm looking for the GoPro session because I'm heading to Hawaii next week, and I really, really want to get that GoPro session back to have just one more camera to be able to record with, and hopefully it's all in one piece. That's the other trick. Anyway, so that's what's going on today. Talk to you in about 2 hours when I get to the site. So here we are, about to cross the river, as you can see. It's a pretty lovely day. My plan is to cross right about there. I think that's the shallowest. We'll see once we get over there, but I'm pretty certain I can cross this. It's not that deep. Right there looks like the most likely spot. So I'm going to change into my shorts and sandals and cross, and then we'll do a little reconnoiter and change back. We'll see how I feel. I at least put my hiking boots and shoes back on. And yep. So here we are. Far up as I think the quad fell, and as you can see, reasonably far up. I'm pretty reasonably sure that the quad is down from here. So my plan is to walk in stripes perpendicular to the fall of the mountain, looking for the quad, just looking down. Reasonably sure using that. If it's here, I'll find it. So I'm just going to do that until basically I get to the river. It's got to be here somewhere. Where? It's a good question. Unless some rancher picked it up, it's possible. I've seen signs of human activity down at the base of the hill, but it's pretty unlikely. So I'm just going to do that. I'm just going to follow this. Horizontally along the mountain, and I'm gonna find it hopefully fairly soon, because yeah, this is kind of hard work climbing mountains. Anyway, that's it for now. Next update, probably about 2 hours or so. Today was attempt number 4. I drove up with a good idea of where it should be, and realized that it should be above that line where I said before, and that's where I searched, and I found it fairly quickly. So it helps if you know where you're searching.
So here we are, number 4 to retrieve the quad. This time I'm actually reasonably sure I know where it is.
We gotta cross the river yet again, and it's gotta be up along that ridge, somewhere in there. So that's where I'm going to be searching. Hopefully I'll find it.
I hope so, because this is going to be the last attempt. So if not, I'm screwed.
Lost a quad, and it would be the first quad I've lost, but I've lost 2 in total right now. So here we go.
Okay. This is cool. Look what I just found. Good, I found it, except for the fact that
there is no GoPro. That's what I was worried about. So the GoPro obviously fell somewhere. The question is where. So I'm gonna go and hike back up the mountain. I'm gonna leave that right there. You can see where it was looking. I was looking at. All looks pretty intact. Battery is obviously dead, but everything looks good. Now, and the GoPro. That's gonna be a chore. His GoPros are notoriously difficult to spot. But I'm gonna hike up and see if I can find it. All right, Chit, wonder of wonders. Just a little bit up from the quad. What do I find? I find a GoPro. A little bit worse for wear. Broken lens. And I bet that bitch still turns on. Hey, how about that? Result. I'm going home early today. Woo woo. Right. Result. Signing off. Going home and celebrating. And just to show you where I found it, up in that ravine there is where I found it. I originally thought it was over by these trees over here. So it's not too far off, pretty close. Definitely got line of sight from river. How about that?
I'm chuffed.
All I need is my alien six pack that I lost in Hawaii, and I can claim that I've never lost quad. That would be a good result. We'll see if that actually happens. Fingers crossed. And back at the car. As you can see, went across the river, no problems. It's really windy today. I'm glad I didn't bring my quad. I thought about it. But no. This is the end of a 5-month quest to get my quad back, and I did it. I'm so pleased. We're about to get in the car, fire it up, and see if the GoPro charges. Let's find out. I'm gonna take the memory card out first. Memory card still looks good. Plug it in, turn the car on, plug it in, see if this baby charges. And we have a light. Look at that. Look at that. Hello. Let it charge up and see if it'll actually turn on and record. That'll be a result. All right, if it does, I'm swearing by GoPro for the rest of my life. These things are great. It's down there charging away. Cool. Test of the x24 that I just found today. Changed nothing. I've freed up the motors because they were all packed with sand. As you can hear, there's still a little bit of sand in them. I'm not going to worry too much about that. I just want to see if it hovers. Changed out some of these screws that had rusted. Put a screw in this arm because it had fallen out. Not sure where it went, but it had fallen out. And that's it. The rest of it is stock. Just like I found it. I'm even recording this on the GoPro that was on this quad and spent 6 months on the mountain. So if everything works, it'll be really freaking amazing. So I'm just going to change out these props here and we're going to test hover it. It flies. Okay, how's that for a result? How is that for a result? As you can see, everything is in working order. I didn't change a single thing on the quad, just battery and the props, and that's it. And it worked. So I'm pretty happy about that. And the GoPro worked as well. So yeah, expect another video soon with all the flights that I made. There's some good flights there.